to the final game of the night, the D1 Championship here at the DCHL between Puck University in brown and the Red Coats in white. I'm your play-by-play man, Jason Stitcha, and play has started in favor of the Red Coats. Quick shot there by Mike, but it is saved by Jason Stelter in net for Puck U. Kept in by Josiah. Joe Shea trying to make something happen. Swings it around, back and forth, doing battle with John. John doing a good job of boxing him out, forcing him to the corner. And still in the corner, as now Joe buys himself some time, but it's taken and moved forward. Quick pass, but it's intercepted by Mike, intended for Paul Steintz, or rather Sean Miller. Still kept in play by Puck U. Emily Yox with the shot, it goes well wide. Deflects back out to Sean Miller. Sean Miller, good pass, but it's still in front. No shot taken there. That shot will be taken, and Emily Yox opens the scoring in this matchup. 25 seconds into it, Puck University now leads 1-0. Ball popped right out to Emily Stick, and she did not miss. Just like that, folks, very, very, very early in the matchup. Puck University is ahead, but still plenty of hockey to play before this matchup is decided. I expect multiple scoring changes in this matchup. That is Paul Steintz. He deflects it to the net, where Kevin Shea is forced to cover it up. Redcoats not having the start to this matchup they wanted. But it is the start that they were given as Paul wins that. Quick shot save, it's high in the sky. It was batted down. Actually batted on net, I believe, but no harm, no foul. It's out now. Redcoats trying to move it forward. They deflect it down along the boards. Chipped out by Jason Maxstein. It comes all the way down. Kristen will stop it up and then helped out the rest of the way, but not out the zone yet. Goes past Paul's stick. Paul up to his teammate along the boards. Play continuing in the corner. And once again finds his way to Paul, but he can't do anything with it. Good defense there by the Redcoats. They get it out to center. And now John Grisham moving with the breakaway shot. Saved by Jason Stelter. He had to drop his stick to make it, but he succeeded. And that one went all the way down. No icing. Wendy Jason plays it forward, batted down by Emily. Right to Josiah. Josiah Renton moving it forward just below us. Deflected off of Jake Smith's stick. Now taken the other way by Joe. Joe, quick shot save with the blocker of Kevin Shea. He tried to catch it, and in fact, John had to help it out the rest of the way. Jake Smith, a quick shot, and gloved nicely by Kevin Shea. Might have went high had he not gloved it, but better safe than sorry there. It looks like Redcoats will get a bit of a line change here. Scott Bode and Ann Weiscarver out for that team. Save again by Kevin Shea. He steers it aside to the corner. Play behind the nets. Retway moving with it. Nice move around to get by Emily. Chips it high out. And John beats Scott to the ball. Has to take it around his own net. Wiley Ruberg with the pressure there. Able to keep it in play. Scott couldn't get a handle on it though, and now it comes all the way down to Ann. Ann chips it back to Tway. Tway dumps it, but not deep enough. Michelle's there to stop it. She gets it down, but not far enough there. Good deflection by Scott Bode. Play continues. Wiley, good pass to Josiah. Quick shot, and that one caught in the glove of Jason Stelter. So the goalies here, both of them have a couple quick flashes of the glove and are able to make the saves for their teams. Came out to Ann, chipped aside, her stick got lost. Breakaway opportunity here. Quick shot, save by Kevin Shea. I don't know if it's in yet. Whistle blew, I don't know if we have a goal here. And it doesn't look like it. Carlos Cruz, the referee here, waving it off, saying no goal. Kevin had control of it, it looked like. Either that or he lost sight of it. Either way, no goal.
From what I'm hearing, Kyle says he blew the whistle dead for the ball went in, so it's no goal. He lost sight of the ball, he blew the whistle dead.
Good breakaway opportunity by Puck University, but it doesn't work out for them. That one went all the way back. No icing here. Stelter stops it for Michelle. She's able to play behind the net for John. John trying to get by Scott. He does so. Wiley with the pressure there, so he's forced to get rid of it in a hurry. Still in. Nice keeping by Tway. He got it to Mike. Mike couldn't do anything but dump it deep there. Played up the boards and back around. Oh! It came out. Wiley almost had a goal. A good stick by Michelle to deflect it wide. And now that one. Deflect all the way down. It's going to be icing here? Yes, indeed it will. Someone was calling for a penalty, but I don't think they're going to get it. Certainly didn't see anything myself to warrant any penalties, but who knows? And folks, as you see it out there in the black helmet, Ariel waiting for a pass. It doesn't come. I, of course, will be sure to mention Ariel about 1,000 times in this broadcast, as he called me out for not recognizing him in the one last week. And if there's one thing I've learned in my years of doing this, is that if you make a mistake, someone will let you know about it. But it's all in good fun, folks. It's all in good fun. And of course, Ariel has an audience here, his family here today to watch him hopefully score a couple goals for his team. That one came out and was steered aside by Jason Stelter. Deflected in by Kristen, just as quickly hit out. Another opportunity here for Puck U. Quick shot, and that one does find the back of the nets. And that'll be a goal for Puck U. 2-0 now is the score for Puck University. There's only so many breakaways a goalie can stop before it's too many. Some would argue that one breakaway is too many. I think I'm in that camp. I don't like breakaways. Well, I don't like them when I'm playing in net anyway. Joe Shea dumps it deep, intended for Mike. Mike trying to play it down. Ariel with the attempted stick. Doesn't make contact with it. Oh, offside. Kevin Shea loved it, so no harm anyway, but it's actually going to go all the way down as a result of it being a shot on net on the offside. It's not what Puck University wanted. Quick bang bang play. But an infraction is an infraction. Kept in by Tway. He tried to put the shot on. It was hit aside by Paul. That's a long shot that goes wide of the nets. Tway trying to get it off the back wall. Oh, nice spin around shot. That one comes out. Kevin Shea in the perfect position, the butterfly, to make the save there. And Weisgarver trying to get by Paul. Paul, his shot goes wide through the crease, as a matter of fact. Paul Steintz running every which way, trying to make something happen. But all that happens there is an icing. Just over 7 minutes to play in the first period. We have a running clock here in the DCHL. Clock will only stop in the instances of timeouts or in the final minute of the third period, and only then if it's a one goal deficit or less. Mike was calling for the pass at the point. It didn't come. Jake Smith got it down. Quick shot, save with the pad again by Kevin Shea. Another quick shot attempt. It actually was a pass attempt. It went by everybody. Kept in by John. That one is not kept in. It went by him. Wiley Ruberg trying to run it down. She will not beat Michelle to the ball. She gets there first. Is able to get it by John and back up to the other John. Comes right out to Ann. Ann Weisgarver. Off the wall. Goes to Jake Smith. Jake Smith dumps it deep into the corner. Back to Tway. Tway. Up the boards to John. It goes by everybody. Wiley is there. And she gets it legally onside, so White can't advance. They do. Oh, nice deflection there. Quick chance. Shot saved by Jason Stelter. He had to fall sideways for it, but it's good enough for another notch in the save column. John Grisham trying to work his way around by himself. A good pass. Pass to Ariel, but the shot went wide. Wiley Ruberg can't get by Jake Smith. Jake plays it nicely up the boards. Tries to run around everybody. Ariel's going to be the first one there for it. Ariel tried to play it up the boards. Got by everybody. Jason Maxstein was able to keep it in. Batted down by Scott. Jake Smith. And the hand pass is actually the ruling. So it's going to come out of the zone. You can only legally hand pass it in your own defensive zone, and Puck University was not in their defensive zone, so as a result, stops your play and a faceoff in the neutral zone. Josiah wins it forward. Jason Maxstein, though, is there for it. Gets it across to the other side. Scott Bode tried to keep it in, couldn't do so. I beg your pardon, he can do so. Uses his feet and succeeds on the second attempt. It's batted down, and it hit the backboard. Ariel tried to hit it out of the air with his hands and instead hit it into the backboard, so play will be stopped. Sean Miller trying to say it should be in the defensive zone, but that is incorrect. Faceoff should actually be where it is right now, in the neutral zone. Played out to Jason. Oh, quick shot by Jason Maxstein, but it was able to be saved by Kevin Shea. Jason Maxstein and somebody exchanging words, someone on the bench, I think, but it was an accurate shot. If it would have went wide, it would have gone for icing, but it did not. It was on net cleanly, so that's why the faceoff was where it was. Josiah Renton couldn't do anything with it. Chipped in. Sean Miller trying to get past Kristen. It goes on net, and Kevin Shea forced to dive for it, and Sean Miller leapt over him like a lion in the African savannah. I think that's what lions do. I don't know. I've seen The Lion King. They did a lot of leaping in that movie, right? Face-off won by the Redcoats. Josiah tried to get it for it. Oh, quick shot saved by the shoulder of Kevin Shea. Ariel doing battle with Sean Miller. Sean Miller dragging it down. Shot to the point, but it's flubbed and then taken by Scott. Oh, still in the zone. Nice keep there. Sean Miller, quick shot. But again, Ariel doing a good job of clogging up the shooting lane and blocking it before it got to the net. Quick dump in by Wendy Jason of the Redcoats. Last broadcast, I kept calling the Redcoats Red Storm. That was their previous name. Oh, a slide by Josiah, but referee's letting it go and results in a goal against. Quick shot past Kevin Shea, and that'll be the third goal unanswered from Puck University. 2.5 to go in the first. The Redcoats on their heels a little bit. This is D1 Division. This is the highest level of play in DCHL. And you see why, folks. Quick shots, quick passing, a lot of cycling, a lot of great goaltending. It's not quite the NHL, but it'll do for our purposes. Offside, so the faceoff will come in the neutral zone. Taken by Mike. He chips it forward by Michelle and then helped further along by Joe Shea. He's got a chance. Quick pass. And Wiley Ruber connected with the shot, but Jason Stelter connected with the save. Jason Stelter takes up a lot of the net, and that is not a weight comment. That is just a fact that with all those pads, he takes up a lot of the net, and he was able to slide across in the nick of time. Oh, and it went off of Carlos's shin. He's still upright somehow. life of a referee is sometimes a dangerous one. Wiley, with a chance here, takes it into the corner, forced to run it down. Michelle on her tail. Played forward by Puck Yu, swiped aside by Ann. Tway holds up, but it's stolen from him, hit to the other side. Up to Paul. Paul, quick shot, save with the blocker. It's in the air, batted down by Mike. And taken out by Joe Shea. He gets by everybody. 2-on-1. Oh, and there's going to be a slash here. And I believe it's going to be a slash. Joe Shea went down hard. And unfortunate occurrence there. Joe Shea does not wear traditional hockey gloves. I believe he wears lacrosse gloves, something.
They're gardening gloves.
Gardening gloves, actually. I think it what it looks like. So it takes a hard one to the wrist. But he's able to walk upright under his own power. We'll see if he comes back to play in this matchup. Joe Shea's a tough dude, so I'm sure we'll see more of him.
And no call.
So,
no call for slashing?
No, there is. So Puck University will be shorthanded here. They have four attackers out there. 2 minutes to think about what they did. And they ice it down legally there. Oh, comes off the back wall. Kevin Shea plays it up and out of the zone. John having a bit of difficulty getting possession. Good forechecking by the Redcoats there. John Grisham moving forward with it. Michelle clogging up the lane, deflects that shot aside, gets it to Emily Ox. Emily Ox tried to clear it down. She does so. And that'll do it for this first period, folks. The Redcoats will continue to have a power play heading into the second, but they still find themselves down 3-0. Who will win the second period? I don't know. I am not a predictor of the future, but we will see here in a few moments. Stick around for more DCHL action here on the DCHL Network. Opening faceoff of the second period here, folks. The ECHL D1 Division Championship matchup between Puck University in brown and the Redcoats in white. Not in red, but in white. I'm your play-by-play man, Jason Stitcha. The Redcoats start this period on the power play. Quick shot there is saved by Jason Stelter. It's held up by Ariel. He gets it down to the near side boards. Back to Ariel. He's got some space to work with. The clock hasn't started, now it has. Free hockey, a couple extra seconds of free hockey. We try to be generous here in the DCHL. Played out to John. John, up to Ariel, quick shot, swing and a miss on it. Comes all the way down. Stopped by Kevin Shea, and he will play it forward. Oh, played it right into the gut of the referee. Kristen trying to get it out of danger. She does so. Ariel now with a lot of time and space to work with. Long pass all the way to John. John tried to one-time pass it. Couldn't do so. It goes to Wendy now. Wendy Jason. Quick shot. Save. With the glove of Jason Stelter. He'll hold on to that. So quick bang-bang plays here. The Redcoats getting some good shots on net on the power play, but none of them have found the back of the net yet. Still some time left on Puck University's slashing penalty that they took in the first. 20 seconds, I believe, I just heard from down below. Oh, turned over to front. Tway with a good shot. Steered aside and now taken by Sean Miller. Puck University being aggressive here on this PK. Oh, nice move around. And that's going to find the back of the net. Faked out the netminder. So the aggressive PK pays off. Puck University now up by a score of 4-0. And no matter what the Redcoats try to do, they just don't have an answer for Puck U. At least not yet. Face off one to the boards by Puck U. Scott tried to play it forward and He thought Josiah was going to get after it, but Josiah stayed in his spot, so miscommunication there. Scott still is battling for it along the boards. Still in play, but not for long, as it is now out. No, it is in. Beg your pardon. Tway kept it in. Jason Maxtein now has possession. He will probably get this out of the zone. Indeed, he does. Chips it high in the sky. Kicked aside by Ann. Scott gives it to Josiah. Quick shot, but it's not enough of it. It goes well wide and slow of the net. Josiah. Shot is deflected down. Continues to move with it. Takes it in the corner. Tries to fake out Sean. He does so. No wraparound to be had there. Those. Jason Maxtein was guarding the back door quite nicely. A pass in front intended for a while. He had actually bounced over everybody's stick, including Tway's. He had a chance at a one-time shot. Instead, deflected down. Kevin Shea will come out. Play this forward. All the way down to Wiley. Wiley actually gives it to Mike. Mike, quick shot. Wide of the net. And Wiley couldn't get a handle on it, so Sean Miller will take it forward. A potential 3-on-2 here if he can gain the zone in time. He doesn't. Good back checking by Mike. Quick shots. Wide of the net. Sean Miller now with possession. Gets it back up to the wall. Another shot, and that one's going to find the back of the net. Puck University just putting on a goal-scoring clinic in this matchup. 5-0 now is the score. The Redcoats having difficulty. A hat has been thrown onto the floor because of the hat trick. Hat-trick goal results in a 5-0 lead. One forward by the Redcoats. Joe Shea, though, couldn't get there before Michelle. Michelle misplayed it off the board, so Joe continues to have possession. Wendy tried to hammer it home, couldn't do so. Now it's taken by Sean Miller. Sean, quick shot, goes wide. Kevin Shea steers it aside a little bit for Mike. Mike not able to get by Emily Ox. Sean Miller, delaying, swing and a miss on the one-time chance. Another shot, and that one's in again! That's 4 goals for him.
What's his name?
Josh with 4 goals. Had one hat trick, working on another. His family's up here cheering him on. It might be the good luck charm, I don't know. One forward, and then just as quickly one back. Suppose you can say that was contested. That one shot just wide by Paul Steins. Played up, kept in, and then played out. Will it go far enough for an icing? Indeed it will. Joe Shea tried to win the race, couldn't do so, and wisely held up. I mentioned at the end of the first period, Joe Shea had gotten slashed, and gonna see if maybe he could have gotten back onto the floor, if the injury would have kept him out. It has not. Joe Shea is still playing, still fighting, still trying to get his team on the board here. 6-0 is the score. Oh, that one was trickling wide. It went behind Kevin, but Ariel was able to save a goal there. John Grisham plays it forward for Wendy, but it gets by everybody. Nice keep, and I'm trying to reposition the camera, folks. It's going every which way on me. Play to the wall. Played out. Ariel stops it. Plays it forward. Wendy couldn't touch it as her team was offside. And Jason Maxtein plays it high in the sky. Too high. As it hit the ceiling. Would have been a delay of game in the third period. It is not the third period yet. So as a result, oh, indeed, I think it will. So yes, Puck University will be shorthanded here. Jason Maxtein taking a delay of game penalty for hitting the ceiling. Quick shots, wide of the net. So the Redcoats did not score on their first power play opportunity. They now have another. See if their luck is better this time. Back and forth we go. That shot goes wide of the net. John Grisham now with control to Ariel, but Ariel's shot does not connect as well as he would have liked. It trickles to the wall. Kept in by John. Good play by him to break up the clear attempts. Swung to the side. Ariel pinches in. Couldn't get it by Paul Steins. Paul now moving forward with it. Paul, quick shot. Saved by Kevin Shea. Good shot. Better save. Yeah, folks, normally I don't have trouble with the camera, but today it is not cooperating, so my apologies if I miss anything important. It's all important, of course, but there are varying degrees of importance, I feel like. Hit off the wall. No icing here. Says Puck University continues to be shorthanded. Josiah Renton ships it up the wall, looking for a fortuitous play. And he's still stuck in the corner. Pass intended for Wiley. Goes off the boards to Tway. Tway, quick shot. Saved by Stelter. Another quick shot by Wiley there. But it is deflected wide of the net. Kept in by Tway. Only for a moment. It's out now. Jake Smith takes it behind. And he's just killing time, folks. He's not even looking for a good shot. He does take one. It goes wide. And he's able to now take another shot. Save again by Kevin Shea. And you can see, folks, that aggressive penalty kill. Whistle came late. But it did come. Some confusion here. I think the referees are trying to figure out what had happened. I believe Puck University was saying that they should have been actually at full strength sooner than they were. But regardless, they are at full strength now. Hit all the way down. Tway has possession. Chipped out, went past Joe's stick. Now down for Josiah. Oh, bouncing ball is deflected off a body and then saved by Jason Stelter. Went off his shoulder. There's going to be some type of call here. And no, they're just deliberating on where to put the faceoff. They will put it at Stelter's glove side. It's kept in by Ariel. A shot goes just wide of the net. And it's still in front. Joe Shea back to Ariel. Ariel, quick shot. Deflected by a couple different bodies and comes off the back wall. Joe Shea steers it to the side. Only person there for it is Emily Yock. She gets it by Kristen. Kristen to Joe. Comes all the way down to Kevin Shea. He chooses to play it. Off the boards, up to Kristen. Kristen couldn't get by Michelle. Michelle poked it to Emily, and her shot was saved by Kevin Shea. Played out to Joe Shea. He's held up for the briefest of moments. He still has possession. Play out to Ariel again. Ariel, quick shot. It's deflected by Emily's stick. Goes high in the sky. Batted down by John. And he'll choose to dump it. Come on for a change there. Another quick shot goes wide of the nets. And then finally comes out Joe Shea with a chance at it now. Quick shot. Oh, save with the shoulder of Jason Stelter. Joe Shea gets his own rebound, tries to get it to Mike, who was waiting at the back door but couldn't make enough contact with it to put the shot on net. Mike, another quick shot. Save again with the pad of Stelter. Joe Shea tried to pass that center. Nobody there. It's taken down now. Puck University moving forward. And that shot deflected high over the netting. And Kevin Shea, who looked like he was going to come out for it, instead let Mike have it. Comes out. Ariel calls for it. He's going to take it. Ariel to John. Quick shot wide of the net. Wiley trying to poke in. Get past Jason Maxstein. She cannot do so. He holds up and gets up the boards. Couple of people along the wall. And there's going to be a stoppage of play here as the Redcoats were coming off for a line change, and the clear actually went up the boards and, beg your pardon, went up the boards and actually into the open door. Cook University wants a too many players penalty. Carlos Cruz, the referee, saying that it was a legal line change, so no penalty to be had. Draw will come one zone deeper here. If it's any consolation to Puck U. John gets it by one player, not another. Jason Maxstein with a good poke there. Back and forth we go. Paul Steins now. Good pass to Woolley. But Wiley Ruberg able to get it to Tway. Tway trying to put the shot on. Goes off the wall instead. Jason Maxstein holds up. It's still in the zone. White is still free to advance if they want to. But Jason Maxstein just killing time at this point. Long pass attempt. It's going to go off everybody. It's going to go for icing, as a matter of fact. Jason Maxstein was looking for a long pass. Instead, put too much mustard on that hot dog and ended up icing it as a result. Faceoff win by Puck U, but the Redcoats are the ones that get possession of it off the far wall. Tway, swing and a deflection off of Paul's stick, and Paul now still with possession and still onside. Good blocker save by Kevin Shea. It comes all the way out and now comes out to Paul Steins. He stops it, puts the shot on, goes well wide of the net off the wall and off to the side where Tway pokes it and then takes it forward. Over Michelle's stick, John will be the first one to it. John, carrying up the boards, just over a minute to play, scores 6-0 in favor of Puck U. Redcoats trying to get on the board. A goal, even just one goal, could shift the momentum in their favor, but they gotta work hard for it. They're not getting any shots on net here during this offensive zone possession because Puck University is doing a good job of clogging up the passing lanes. Played up, and then played out. And a breakaway chance here, but Ann Weiscarver able to extend her stick out with one hand and deflect it to the wall. Comes all the way back down. Puck U has to touch up. They do. Paul Steins. Good bang bang play to Emily Yock. She gets it deep. And all the way around for Ariel. Ariel tried to play it up for John. Instead, it went to Michelle's stick. Jake Smith now. Quick shot. Oh, and a glove save by Kevin Shea. The whistle came. Looked like Shea might have wanted to play to Ariel, but instead the referees blew the play dead. And the buzzer will blow the period dead. One more period of regulation. Things look bleak for the Redcoats, but they are not out of this by any stretch of the imagination. They just got to put the shots on nets, and more importantly, get any rebounds that Jason Stelter gives up. Are they going to get back into this? Will they get back into this? We'll see here in the third period of play. I've been your play-by-play man, Jason Stitches. Stick around for the exciting pulse-pounding conclusion of the D1 Championship here on the DCHL Network. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. A false start there. Josiah jumped the faceoff, so Wendy Jason will take his place. I'm your play-by-play man, Jason Stitcher. This is the D1 Division Championship in the DCHL. Third and final period of regulation. Puck University ahead 6-0. So a long hill, a high hill to climb for the Redcoats. But it is possible for them to get back in, and very, very possible, in fact. Scott Bode with possession in the corner. Gets it up the boards. Seen and read nicely by Emily Yock. She will get it out of the zone. Ariel will run it down. Ariel tried to get it out, batted down by Emily. She had the first goal of the game to open up this bevy of goals by Puck U. Couldn't find one there. Joe and Ariel doing battle here. in the corner. Referee's calling for them to move it. Jake Smith comes away with possession. Gets it by Kristen Emily. Tried to pull the trigger, couldn't do so. It's off to the corner now. And Scott got it around to Ariel. And Ariel has a little bit of space to work with. Not too much, but enough to get it to Josiah. Josiah with a nice little fancy backhand swat down, which he was able to recover and bringing forward. Ariel all the way up to the point. He's called for the pass. He got the pass, but couldn't settle it down in time. Nice play there by Josh. Emily tried to get it deep, and Josh is offside. Can't do that. And so, as a result, we'll have a face-off right below us. Josh Lerner has 4 of the 6 Puck University goals in this matchup. He has been on an offensive tear for them today. Face-off won by the Redcoats. Tway chips it high for Wiley Ruberg. He tried to get in center, intended for Mike. Instead, it came out. Oh, and a nice play by Josh again. He is held up by Ann Weiscarver, who chipped it out. Nice play by her. And Tway, with some time to work with, save by Jason Stelter with the blocker. He's made a couple good stops today. Play continues in the corner. Tough to get a shot from that angle. Jason Maxton couldn't make anything. Or Scott, rather, couldn't make anything happen there due to Jason Maxteen. Jason Maxteen takes it forward now, swings it to the side for Sean Miller. Sean, swing and a miss on the shot attempt. It's poked out. Now Puck U has to retreat back in their own zone. Wiley keeps it in play for the Redcoats. Quick shot again, and that one is going to find the back of the net. So just like that, folks, the Redcoats are finally on the board. They cut the deficit to 5. Bang, bang, play in front. Rebound opportunity. And it finds its way past Jason Stelter. Up to Wiley. Wiley Ruberg off the boards, intercepted, and that played out to Sean Miller. Quick shot, save with the stick by Kevin Shea. Goes around, but not quite out yet. Tway forced to chip it high. Nice play by Wiley. She poked it to Joe Shea. Joe Shea gains the zone, gets it back to Mike. Mike, quick shot, but it's blocked aside by Josh. Josh doing a little bit of everything here today for Puck U. Played along the boards. Josh has possession once again. Tried a backhand shot. It went well wide. And Tway and Wiley too close to each other, so Wiley had to peel off. And Tway had to play it even deeper into his own zone, and Kevin Shea had had enough of that, said, all right, I'm going to cover this up and kind of just take a breather here. Just over 10 to play, folks. It's going to be a running clock unless the Redcoats can cut this deficit to 1 goal. Otherwise, barring a timeout, play's going to continue uninterrupted. A quick shot there. Nice backhand shot. And another one. And finally covered up by Jason Stelter. But a nice couple chances there by the Redcoats. But they still only have 1 goal. Batted down by John. John still has possession. Oh, nice stick handling by John Grisham. Able to weave around 3 or 4 different Puck U defenders. And he continues to maintain possession in the corner. Played along the wall to Wendy Jason. Wendy couldn't get it by Michelle. Nice block by her. Still in the corner. Still with John. Pass up to Ariel, quick shot, one-timer. Doesn't get to the net due to the amount of traffic, but it was accurate. That one is accurate as well. It's steered aside by Jason Stelter's stick, and John still has possession now. Nice zone time and nice couple shots by the Redcoats. And still in. Good keep by John. Paul with the attempted clear, but it didn't work out the way he had hoped. Michelle, take it around her own team's net. Played up to Emily. Emily, swing and miss on the first clear attempt, succeeds on the second. And Ariel, with possession, plays it. Long pass. He thought he had a teammate there. He did not. Kristen couldn't clear it out. Instead goes to Emily's stick. Still in the zone, Jason Maxtein winds up for the one-timer, goes high in the sky, hits the back wall, and comes down. Paul Steins. Oh, a shot from a tough angle is steered aside by Kevin Shea's stick. Back up to the wall again, Jason Maxtein. Another quick shot attempt goes off the back wall. Oh, Kevin had intended to fall on it, couldn't do so. He's still down on the ground. Nice toe save by him there. And now he's finally up on two legs. Paul looking for a deflection off of Kevin's pad. None was to be had. And that's going to be icing, but the Redcoats will take it. A fast and frantic couple minutes there. You can change. You can conduct a line change here on an icing in the DCHL. In the NHL, of course, you cannot do that, but in the DCHL, it's all good. Another quick shot, and it goes in. Seventh goal of the night for Puck University, and that one's going to be had by Joe Fruschioni, however you pronounce his last name. It's all good. Another face-off win by Puck University. Jason Maxtein gets it back to Joe. He just had a goal. Is he looking for another? He is not. Gets by him. Scott tried to pinch in. Couldn't do so. Tway able to get it up, but not quite out yet. He does that time. Him and Jake Smith doing battle. It goes out to Ann Wisecarver. Chips it forward to Josiah. Josiah. Tried to play it forward, couldn't do so. It comes back out. Back and forth we go. Jason Maxtein now with possession. Holds up. He has it along the wall. He hasn't put a shot on yet. And now Josiah with a breakaway. Able to put the shot on the net. Think Jason Stelter got a piece of it. It comes out. Scott keeps it in one-handed style. But it goes to Jake Smith, and now he will carry it into the offensive zone. Ships it. Into the corner. Tway and Jake Smith doing battle. It's loose. It's like this is very loose. See how it's tilting? Play continues here. Looks like we got the camera issues worked out, at least for the moment. Play continues. Joe has a 2-on-1 here if he can get it to Sean Miller. He does not. He instead puts the shot on net at a tough angle at about the red line, and Kevin Shea is able to squeeze his pads and make the save. Just over 5 to go. 7-1 is the score. Puck University looking at the DCHL Cup is saying, I want that, and I want it now, but they have to wait, assuming the score stays the same. Shot toward the net, Kevin Shea plays it out, intended for Joe Shea. They both have the same sounding last name, but they do not have the same spelling of the last name. Kevin Shea is spelled S-H-A-Y, Joe Shea is spelled S-H-E-A. Played back to the wall. Sean Miller, quick shot and another save by Kevin Shea. Puck University showing no mercy. They're ahead by 6, but they're still taking shots on net. 4.5 to go. Played out, and then the shot is deflected, I believe, by Mike's body. Played back to Sean Miller. Mike's going to be the first one there for it. Redcoats, take it behind the net. Given to Kristen. And she is able to get it out of the zone. Fuck you, backing up. Josh puts it by everybody. Oh, Emily Yox, though, able to make the save, or make the deflection, and keep it in play. Back and forth we go. Joe Shea now with a breakaway. Chance at it, but it was broken up by Puck Yu. And stared aside by Jason Stelter. You know, the camera's coming off, folks, so I'm going to attempt to actually be an actual cameraman and just hoist it on my shoulder. I don't want to lose this thing. They're going to let Suds know. Welcome back, folks. Camera's still on my shoulder. The tripod is continuing to give me issues, so I'm going to play cameraman for a day, actual cameraman. Joe Shea gets it to Wendy. Shot attempts, but it goes, is deflected wide. Dumped down. Played out by Kevin Shea. He came way out to make that swipe. Back and forth we go. Kicked aside and then hit in. Kevin Shea had a man coming on him, but played it up to Ariel. And the give credit to the Redcoats. They continue to fight hard and continue to push forward in the zone with Gusto. And deflected down. Nice little spinorama move. A quick shot and a goal. How about that? Kind of took it around his back. And now Suds is here to help me out. And
we'll take a break. We'll be right back shortly, folks. Don't go away.
Welcome back, folks. Still messing around with the tripod. 50 seconds and counting here. Actually, 40. As I continue to play cameraman. Puck University with another goal to make it 8-1 now. They're going to be hoisting the DCHL D1 Division Cup. A hard-fought matchup. Redcoats certainly gave it their all as that shot by Jake Smith is saved by Kevin Shea. He's faced a large number of shots. 50, 60, 100? Certainly, sure it feels that way. As that one is played behind the Puck University net. And they're just doing nothing but killing time at this point, folks. And that'll do it. Time has been killed. And the cup has been won by the boys and girls in brown. Puck University triumphing over the Redcoats by a score of 8-1. Stick around. We got the trophy presentation coming up for you in just a moment here on the DCHL Network.
We'll do it all, everything on our own. We don't need anything or if I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world? I don't quite know how to say said too much, they're not enough. If If I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world? Forget what we're told before we get too old. Show me a garden that's bursting into life. Let's waste time chasing cars around our heads. I need your grace to remind me to find my own. If I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world? Forget what we're told before we get too old. Show me a God that's bursting into life. Just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?